Okay, so we're going to take this game a bit further now, and we're going to turn it into a proper two-player game with a winner and a loser. So we need this code. If we're doing a two-player game, we need this code to be able to run twice. Okay, now we could repeat it for each player. That would work, but that would be a slightly inefficient way. So what we can do is we can turn it into a function. Okay, so a function, if you're not sure, check out the Learn to Code tutorials on playlist on this website, on this channel, and that will explain what a function is. But essentially, a function is a program inside another program. So what we're going to do is I'm going to make a function called def. I'm going to call it game, okay? And we've got the brackets and the colon. And anything you want to run in the function, we have to indent. So what we're going to do is we are going to indent everything. Okay, so control right square bracket or command right square bracket if you're on a Mac. So we are going to now create a couple of variables right down the bottom here. Okay, so just this is outside of the function. So we're going to call it P1 and P2, and these are going to be the player names. So input please enter player one, and then likewise same for this one here. Okay, so this will be the names of the players. So what we need to do is we need to be able to return the player's score from this function. Okay, so to do that, what we can do is we can use something called return. So the way this will work is down here inside the function, we write the word return, and then we return what we want to get out of the function. And what we want is the dart count, because the person who throws the lowest darts is the winner. So that will return dart count out of the function. So what we need to do now is run the function. So what we can do is we can make another variable, call it dart count p1, and we'll say game. Now what this little bit of code will do, we'll also do one for the second player, dart count p2 equals game. Okay, so oops. What this will do, this will run the function for player one firstly. Okay, so it runs it because we've got this, and it will return the value, the amount of darts that the player one throws into this variable, and then the game will run again, and same thing, it will return the amount of darts that player two throws into this variable. Okay, so what we can do is we can then print out the scores. So let's see, print player one got dart count P1, and same thing, let's just copy that. Player two got dart count P2. So this should give us the counts for the amount of darts thrown. So using the variable is sorry, using the function is quite efficient here, because we're not copying this game code, we're just using it twice but extracting two different numbers from it which we can assign to these variables. So let's just check it out and see if it works. So this is quite a short game, this is 200. So player name called Jim, people Bob, so we will see who wins. Looks like Jim is rubbish, so we'll make him the loser. Okay, so here we go. Okay, so player one threw five darts. Okay, so player one was Jim, he threw five darts, and player two threw three darts. Okay, so that is how we can return values from the function to work out who's got what score. Okay, at the moment this is a bit confusing. I'd probably need to tidy it up with a few blank lines and things, which we can look at in the next video.